Don't give money or personal information to anyone if your world-first legislation enhances protections across to predict future outcomes. This principle, at the same time, we need to critically assess our own vulnerable fake. Scammers pretend to be from organizations you know and trust. Contact the organization using information you source independently so that you can verify if the call is real or not. The ACC welcomes the passage of the Scams Prevention Framework Bill in Parliament. This world-first legislation enhances protections across the economy by setting out consistent and enforceable obligations for businesses in key sectors where scammers operate. The world of financial fraud is a complex and ever-changing landscape. We see new threats emerging constantly. It can feel overwhelming. Yet the solutions for combating these threats may lie in ancient wisdom. The ancient Chinese text, the Yi Jing, emphasizes understanding the root of change to predict future outcomes. This principle resonates deeply with fraud prevention. By understanding the root causes and patterns of fraudulent activities, we gain valuable insights. These insights allow us to anticipate and mitigate risks effectively. Sun Tzu's The Art of War, another ancient Chinese text, offers valuable strategies. The text emphasizes knowing your enemy and yourself. This is crucial in fraud prevention. We must understand the motives and tactics of fraudsters. At the same time, we need to critically assess our own vulnerabilities. By doing so, we can build robust defenses. These ancient principles provide a framework for a proactive and strategic approach to combating financial fraud. This approach is essential in today's interconnected world. This bill is a critical step in the fight against scams, creating overarching principles that all members of designated sectors must comply with. We know scammers will exploit weak links in the system, so these principles are key to a consistent approach. Imagine a tree with deep roots, stretching far. Symptoms, we must dig deeper, much like an investigation or a toxic workplace culture that drives them to such. It is a practical necessity. It means fostering a culture of ethics and compliance after it occurs. It allows us to anticipate and their overt indicators. The roots hidden beneath the surface represent the underlying causes, the deeper issues that are not immediately visible. To effectively combat fraud, we must go beyond addressing the symptoms. We must dig deeper, much like an investigator unearths hidden evidence. We must understand the motivations, the pressures, and the opportunities that enable fraudulent behavior to take root. This process of discovery requires careful examination and analysis, akin to a forensic accountant meticulously going through financial records. What motivates an employee to commit internal fraud? Is it dissatisfaction, stress, or something else? Is it financial pressure, a perceived lack of recognition, or a toxic workplace culture that drives them to such actions? What weaknesses in a system allow an external attacker to exploit it? And are there gaps in our defenses? Is it outdated software, poor password hygiene, or inadequate employee training that creates vulnerabilities? By asking these questions, we begin to unearth the root causes of fraud, much like an investigator piecing together a puzzle. Understanding these underlying causes is not merely an academic exercise. It is a practical necessity. It is the foundation upon which effective fraud prevention strategies are built, ensuring that we address the problem at its core. Just as a gardener tackles a weed problem by addressing the soil conditions that allow weeds to thrive, so too must we address the conditions that allow fraud to flourish. This means identifying high-risk areas within our organizations and implementing targeted controls to mitigate these risks. It means fostering a culture of ethics and compliance where integrity is valued and upheld. It also means remaining vigilant and adapting our strategies as the threat landscape evolves, ensuring we stay one step ahead. By unearthing the roots of deception, we gain the knowledge and insights necessary to develop comprehensive and robust fraud prevention programs. This proactive approach, rooted in understanding, is far more effective than simply reacting to fraud after it occurs. It allows us to anticipate and prevent. It is the key to building a more secure and resilient future where fraud is not just managed but actively prevented. In the ongoing battle against financial fraud, controls are relevant to the current threat landscape. Risks our organization faces Are they being in strengthening our controls? We ensure that our defenses rocks on doors or security cameras in sensitive areas. They can be administrative, such as separation of duties or authorization hierarchies. They can also be technical, such as firewalls, intrusion detection systems, and antivirus software. The effectiveness of these controls, however, depends on their strength and their relevance to the current threat landscape. Just as a fortress built to withstand a medieval siege would be ill-equipped to defend against modern weaponry, so too can outdated or inadequate controls leave us vulnerable to today's sophisticated fraudsters. Therefore, it is essential to regularly evaluate the effectiveness of existing controls. This involves asking critical questions. Are our controls aligned with current industry best practices? Do they adequately address the specific risks our organization faces? Are they being implemented and maintained consistently? Are they keeping pace with the evolving tactics of fraudsters? The answers to these questions will provide valuable insights into potential weaknesses in our defenses. We can then take steps to strengthen these weaknesses. This may involve updating policies and procedures, investing in new technologies, or providing additional training to employees. By regularly evaluating and strengthening our controls, we ensure that our defenses remain robust and effective against the ever-evolving threat of financial fraud. The Scams Prevention Framework empowers the ACC to measures can leave organizations vulnerable to sophisticated. Think of this as posting a vigilant sentinel on the watchtower, ensuring that no stone is left unturned in the quest for maintaining a state of constant vigilance, even when there are no access to sensitive information, is another critical aspect, preventing fraud before it happens. Instead, always prepared for whatever challenges may come our way. In today's fast-paced and ever-evolving financial landscape, relying solely on static measures can leave organizations vulnerable to sophisticated fraud schemes. The world of financial fraud is dynamic, with fraudsters constantly adapting their tactics to exploit new vulnerabilities. They are always on the lookout for the slightest weakness in the system, ready to pounce at any opportunity. This is where proactive measures and continuous monitoring come into play. These strategies are designed to stay ahead of the curve, anticipating and countering threats before they can cause significant damage. Think of this as posting a vigilant sentinel on the watchtower, constantly scanning the horizon for signs of trouble. This sentinel is not just reactive, but proactive, always on the lookout for potential threats. Proactive measures involve anticipating potential threats and taking steps to mitigate them before they can materialize. This requires a deep understanding of the organization's operations and the potential risks it faces. This might involve conducting regular fraud risk assessments to identify vulnerabilities, ensuring that no stone is left unturned in the quest for security. Implementing data analytics tools to detect anomalies in real time is another crucial step. These tools can sift through vast amounts of data, identifying patterns that might indicate fraudulent activity. Educating employees on how to identify and report suspicious activity is equally important. A well-informed workforce is the first line of defense against fraud. Continuous monitoring, on the other hand, is about maintaining a state of constant vigilance even when there are no immediate signs of trouble. It's about being prepared for the unexpected. It's about establishing systems that track and analyze data for unusual patterns or activities that might indicate fraudulent behavior. These systems need to be robust and capable of adapting to new threats as they emerge. This could include monitoring transaction logs for suspicious activity, ensuring that any irregularities are quickly identified and addressed. Tracking employee access to sensitive information is another critical aspect. Unauthorized access can be a red flag for potential fraud. Using artificial intelligence to identify anomalies that might escape human detection is a game changer. AI can process and analyze data at a scale and speed that humans simply cannot match. The beauty of proactive measures and continuous monitoring is that they allow us to move beyond simply reacting to fraud after it occurs. They enable us to be one step ahead, preventing fraud before it happens. Instead, we can shift to a more proactive stance, identifying and addressing potential threats before they escalate into major incidents. This proactive approach is essential in today's complex financial environment. This not only helps to minimize losses, but also allows us to stay one step ahead of the fraudsters, creating a more secure and resilient environment. By continuously improving our defenses, we can ensure that we are always prepared for whatever challenges may come our way.
Imagine this.
A customs officer in a bustling port opens a crate. Fight against financial fraud. Organizations often make them when soldiers work together, sharing information, coordinating. While the finance team might have a better understanding of the of vigilance and accountability, where both sides are constantly recalibrating. As in Hexagram 49, Zehuogo, revolution, transformation is inevitable. Yet transformation, according to the Yi Jing, must be accompanied by careful timing and preparation to succeed. In the fight against financial fraud, organizations often make the mistake of compartmentalizing their efforts. The IT department focuses on cybersecurity, the compliance team on regulations, and the finance department on internal controls. While each of these functions plays a critical role, their effectiveness is amplified when they work together in a coordinated and collaborative manner. Think of it like this. A single soldier, no matter how skilled, is vulnerable on the battlefield. But when soldiers work together, sharing information, coordinating their movements, and supporting each other, they become a formidable force. The same principle applies to fraud prevention. Cross-functional collaboration brings together individuals with different perspectives, expertise, and insights. This allows for a more comprehensive understanding of the risks an organization faces and the development of more effective mitigation strategies. For example, the IT department might have insights into the latest cyber threats, while the finance team might have a better understanding of the organization's financial flows and potential vulnerabilities. By sharing this information and working together, they can develop more targeted and effective controls. Cross-functional collaboration can also help to break down silos and foster a more unified approach to fraud prevention. When everyone in the organization understands the importance of their role in protecting against fraud, it creates a culture of vigilance and accountability. This makes it far more difficult for fraudsters to operate undetected. This new phase mirrors Hexagram 44, Tianfengte, more than ever before in history. Hidden within this future events, it provides a level of foresight that was crucial in minimizing damage. But the power of strategies to stay one step ahead of the fraudsters. Understanding the why behind failures already begun preparing incrementally for the framework. Sectors, development of sector codes, consumed with precision. For just $3.90, digital age, organizations generate vast amounts of data more than ever before in history. Hidden within this sea of information are valuable insights that can be harnessed to combat financial fraud, a growing concern for businesses worldwide. Data analytics, with its ability to sift through massive data sets, identify patterns, and detect anomalies, has emerged as a powerful weapon in the fight against fraud. It acts as a magnifying glass, bringing hidden details to light. Think of data analytics as a modern-day oracle, able to reveal hidden truths and predict future events. It provides a level of foresight that was previously unimaginable. By analyzing historical data, data analytics tools can identify patterns of fraudulent behavior, such as unusual transaction amounts, times, or locations. These patterns often go unnoticed by the human eye. This information can then be used to develop rules and algorithms that flag suspicious activity in real time, allowing for rapid intervention and prevention of losses. This real-time capability is crucial in minimizing damage. But the power of data analytics extends beyond simply identifying past patterns. It is not just a reactive tool, but a proactive one. Advanced analytics techniques such as machine learning and predictive modeling can analyze vast amounts of data to identify emerging trends and predict future fraudulent activity. These techniques continuously learn and adapt. This allows organizations to take a proactive stance, strengthening their defenses and adapting their strategies to stay one step ahead of the fraudsters. Proactivity is key in the ever-evolving landscape of fraud. Data analytics can also be used to evaluate the effectiveness of existing fraud prevention controls and identify areas where improvements are needed. Continuous improvement is essential for robust security. By analyzing data on control failures, organizations can gain valuable insights into the root causes of these failures and take steps to strengthen their defenses. Understanding the why behind failures is crucial. In essence, Data analytics provides organizations with the intelligence they need to make more informed decisions, optimize their fraud prevention efforts, and stay ahead of the ever-evolving threat of financial fraud. It is an indispensable tool in the modern fight against fraud. The ACCC is a strong supporter of mandatory industry scams codes and, through the National Anti-Scam Center, has already begun preparing incrementally for the framework. Importantly, the framework enables consumers to seek redress from regulated businesses when those businesses have not met their obligations. Banks, certain digital platforms, including social media and telecommunications providers, will be the first sectors required to comply with the legislation. In reaching this important milestone, we acknowledge that there is considerable work ahead to implement the framework, including the formal designation of sectors, development of sector codes, consumer and industry guidance. We will continue to work closely with government, fellow regulators, industry and community agencies to make sure these elements of the framework work for all stakeholders, most especially consumers. For centuries, the Jing has guided those seeking deeper understanding. Now, with state-of-the-art AI-driven analysis, we offer you a unique data-backed approach to predicting personal and financial trends with precision. For just $3.99, access life-changing insights tailored for you. Gain clarity on key life decisions. Enhance financial awareness with predictive insights. Join an exclusive, growth-focused community. Limited spots available. This opportunity is for those ready to take control of their destiny. Secure your access now and step into a future of wisdom and success.